especially as you start getting older, I think you always have to keep the drive. That's where you've got to turn it up, you know, make safe moves, but, you know, take some risk and try to learn new things.
And for me, as what I've seen with our clients and the reason why we like working with who we like to work with, the biggest risk is actually being more and more of your authentic self. That seems to be harder than oh, I'm going to acquire this new company, or I'm going to buy this apartment building to diversify my income stream or whatever. Mm-hmm. Those things are pretty black and white decisions. But as you get older, the older people that I really respect are the ones who have owned it. They're like, yeah, I'm 40. This is me. I'm so tired of trying to be your version of me. And they finally have grasped what they've been put here on this earth to do. They've aligned their energy. They've combined it with some business strategy. And then that's when you start to see people take off. Like I have this one client who was a corporate HR and she's a lawyer. And one day she goes, I don't like this. I'm in a toxic work environment. I'm out. And she actually figured out how to get them to pay her to leave a toxic work environment. She moved to Mexico. Now she has multiple businesses, one of them consulting people on how to do the same thing that she just did. And she has this freedom because of she said, I don't remember what the age mark was, like 40-ish. She's like, this is not me. I don't like this. Now she's making more money, living on a beach, loving life. And that for me is the greatest feeling of that evolution, right? And teaching other people how to do that. That's how you prevent yourself from becoming obsolete. But she would have never been able to do that if she didn't step into who she was.
That's great. That's great. And he reminds me of another guest that we had. I think she was on episode 94 last season. Deborah Driggs.
You can remember the episode.
Well, I take my guests very seriously.
I see that.
And she, Deborah Driggs, she's a former Playboy playmate. And she basically was like, I go into life and every situation that I go into is, I think, well, what would the best version of me do? Because now that she's older in life,
great question.
There's been many versions of her throughout her life because people change, you know, kind of like the decades change, you know, the 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, you know, people change like that too. So when she gets into a situation, it's like, what would the best version of me do? And I kind of found that mind blown. I mean, I heard things like, hey, what would Jesus do? But not what would the best version of me do?
Of me do. And I love that. Not that I don't love Jesus. I love Jesus and Buddha and Krishna. And we like them all over here. But my love with that statement comes because it had that evolutionary element and that alignment element already baked in. So when I do bioenergetic business coaching with my clients, the very first thing that I focus on with them is how are we going to align your energy? And then take a look and seeing where that misalignment has caused you to stray off of your path from your goals. And those are the first things that we go after. So when you're saying, when she is saying this great quote, like, how do I show up as the best version of me? Sometimes you don't even know who that person is, right? And so then you have to figure that out first. And then you're like, okay, this is the Alea I want to be in. And that means that I need to change this behavior, this mindset, this relationship. This might even have to move. Like, what do you need to change and shake up so that you can actually have the freedom to do that? Because it's easy to say it. And I love that she said it. But then you sit down and you're like, okay, great. I'm going to do the best version of me. And as soon as you sit down and say that, and you're like, and she is who? Have we met her yet? I mean, is there an invitation I need to send out? Like, and then that's when the work begins.
Yeah, that makes me remind, what was that movie, like Multiplicity or something like that?
Oh, with the guy that played Zoolander played Multiplicity, or no?
I forget, but that's a movie where there's a bunch
of the same dude.
Right. Some of them goofy, some of them, exactly. You know, like different alpha male, some of them wimpy, you know, with all the different personalities. Yeah. That's kind of how it's like in a nutshell there. Mm-hmm. So I want to ask you, I know one of the big things that you're big on is email lists and future-proofing your business by building relationships and growing that list.